Hello, welcome back to Going Walkabout, the channel where I create a mobile travel diary. Today we're going to do something that's on my mind for a long time. We're going to create screenshots automated for the iTunes Store. Like anyone else who wants to do something new, you first go to Google. So that's what I also did. Here on Google, I start to type how to automate screenshots on iOS. Enter, and I got to Fastlane. Now, you might have heard of Fastlane, but it's a tool to automate a lot of delivery, creating screenshot processes for iOS. I had heard about it, but it's the article that is really dealing with it. So I had to dive into that. And the documentation is pretty good. Here on the top, if you're new to Fastlane, it tells you how to install and how to get started. If you follow the document, it explains about the alternatives for taking screenshots and why this is very handy and why automation really helps in this case. And here it tells you that it is using UiTest, how to get started with that, and you can quickly implement that. So I followed all the instructions here and I started running, as in the demo here, creating my screenshot. And for some devices I had a result, but for many others I didn't. So what was the problem? I got more errors than screenshots, and that was not what I wanted. So I had to dive into that. After some research, I learned that my UI tests were not functioning the way it should, because they weren't starting from a, let's say, base level starting point. They all had some undetermined state when they started, and that is not good for tests. So I went to Xcode, and I first went to introduce an attribute and a way to reset my device so that I could continue with a clean slate and all my UI tests would behave exactly the same way. So let me show you what I did. So here in Xcode, I have my unit test, my UI test. So it launches the application and then it appends a UI testing command line flag. So based on that command line, then in my application, I can deal with the state of the application. So in my application in the app delegate, after the app is launched, so on the here the command line, so this is actually the application did finish launching and it's almost launched in debug state. When the argument contains that, I'm going to reset the state of the application, and I had to build that reset state function. So the first thing I had to do was to log out the user, because otherwise, sometimes you would be logged in, and otherwise, sometimes you would not be. So I reset the login credentials, I removed the user defaults, I went into the file manager, and I removed the caching folder of all the images, because we need to start with a clean slate, and I also cleaned the persistence of the Firestore. Now, after I had done that, I knew that my application was in a correct and clean slate. And I had a good basis for starting my unit test. Then I could go to my unit test, and in my test code here, I could then check if I end up in my sign-up view, because the application is starting clean. It always gets into the sign-up view because it's not, well, it's actually the first time it's run, so that's the most likely scenario. I need to go to the login. I check if I'm in the login window. Then in the login window, I'm actually setting some login credentials. I press the login button and then I find my tabs, go to the first tab. I take a screenshot, take another screen, go to the next tab, take a screenshot and take another screenshot. Now I can test this except for the screenshots, because if you read the Fastlane documentation, the screenshot will not be taken when you run this from the device. So we need to go and test this first before we can actually start running it from the command line to create the screenshots. So we go into this test and we run this test. And this test will build and it will actually start a simulator that I'll move here on the screen, make it a little bit bigger, and it needs to start it. So we give it a moment to get started. It's starting, it's loading the unit test, and it will start running. It's installing the app, because that's what the unit test is doing. We get into the launch screen, the sign-up window shows up, it goes to the login screen, it sets the credentials, it's logging in, waits, it goes to the first tab, it's loading the images, goes to the second tab, loaded the images, and it goes to the third tab. Now, this goes quite quickly, but the test is now completed and it is done. So this is the part that Fastlane also uses to create the screenshots on the way. So let's go and have a look how that is actually working then, and if we can get the correct screenshots made as we wanted. So we have the simulator that is running, but we don't need it anymore. We go to our fast file and snap file. So if we in the fast file, we just have one action and that is taking the screenshots, but the snap file, what is more important, here we define which devices we want. I limited the list to make it a little bit quicker because it is a time-consuming process. There's the iPhone 8, there's the iPhone X, and we do the iPod. We don't do localizations yet and we run that. Now, we clear the previous screenshots because we want to have a clean slate and we really want to have new screenshots. And I also disabled the running of concurrent simulators. I am having troubles if I run this on concurrent simulators. I have too many unexpected failures. The test is okay, the screenshots work okay, but if I all tie it together, there's too many failures. And this way, it is a lot more robust in doing it. Now, let's go and run this. So while it is running, yeah, it takes a while. We go and have a look at a few things I had to do in Xcode to make this all work. Because we went over that a little bit quickly, but here in Xcode, you see, I assert a true if the sign of view exists. And this works with the accessibility features in Xcode, and that is actually something you can set in your storyboard or in code. In my case, I set this in storyboard. So if I go to the startup storyboard here, and I load that, also takes some time, and my machine is a little bit busy at the moment, but we get into this sign up view controller. If we now go to this view, you can see here in the sidebar, with the accessibility features, I gave it the sign up view identifier. And that is the one that gets recognized by the UI test, and that's also the way you can detect if that screen is loaded. Now, there's one little warning that I ran into, because after I did this, I needed to press this already have an account, go to the sign in. That's what you also could see in my unit test code here. After I find, I press the go to login button. And that button, again, we go to that storyboard, that particular button here also has a sign up view identifier. Now, here you see that accessibility is enabled because the UI test used those accessibility features. But if I do that on the view, if I enable this, suddenly the underlying, the child elements are not recognized by the accessibility features. And it took me quite some time to figure it out. I finally found this in the documentation, but I will warn you, if you use this on the view, don't enable that because then all the other ones become, all the children become invisible. That being said, we can go back to our Visual Studio Code. It is still working. So in the edit, I will speed this up because it is taking too much time. All right, the screenshots are done and we can see them here on the screen. Now, after the process is done, it nicely shows you the screenshots in this HTML page. We see our Explore notification and Trip tab on the iPad Pro. Then we see the same on an iPhone 8 and we see the rest on the iPhone X because I did it for those three devices. Now, if we close this and we go back to Visual Studio Code, we also see here in the results, it created the iPhone 8, X and iPad Pro screenshots and it's all done. And it took actually 550 seconds. So that is close to 10 minutes that we needed to wait. But it's still a lot quicker than do it all manually and it is very consistent. So I'm very happy with the result. Now, the next step is to nicely frame these screenshots in a frame of a phone with some text so that it looks nice. And of course, enable the capabilities to upload it to the iTunes Store. But that will come later when I am going to publish this to the App Store. I just wanted to figure this out so that I could use this into the future. I hope you like this video. If you like, please like and subscribe. If you didn't like the video, subscribe anyway, because the next one might be better for you. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.